Supreme Master Qinghai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Today's episode will be presented in English, Chinese, and overseas, also known as Vietnamese, with subtitles in Arabic, overseas, Bulgarian, Chinese, Czech, English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Russian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Slovenian, Spanish, Telugu, and Thai.
Xin kính gửi lời chào nồng nhiệt đến quý khán giả thương mến. Tôi là Thu Thảo, đến từ tỉnh Cao Bằng hữu tình, đất nước Âu Lạc, còn được biết là Việt Nam. Dãy đất hình chữ S, đất nước Âu Lạc, Việt Nam, là tổng hòa của 54 dân tộc anh em, trong đó có dân tộc Dao, từ ngàn đời nay đã chung sống gắn bó keo sơn. Qua lối hát báo dung, người Dao thổ lộ tình yêu thương và khát vọng về một cuộc sống tốt đẹp hơn. Hát báo dung của người Dao được công nhận là di sản văn hóa phi vật thể cấp quốc gia của Âu Lạc, Việt Nam. Dân tộc Dao hiền lành, cầu chúc quý khán giả giàu lòng nhân ái, được hưởng nhiều niềm vui từ những vũ điệu sắc màu độc đáo của người Dao. Chúng tôi thật vinh hạnh giới thiệu đến quý vị đất nước Âu Lạc, Việt Nam quyến rũ. Người dân chúng tôi kính chúc quý vị vui hưởng tình thương bao la và phước lành từ cõi giới thiêng liêng. Trong hơn 3 thập niên, Thanh Hải Vô Thượng Sư đã soi sáng thế giới bằng giáo lý thiêng liêng. Là một vị minh sư toàn giác, Ngài truyền đạt pháp môn Quán Âm cho những ai khao khát tức khắc tìm lại Thượng Đế tánh bên trong, hầu đạt được giải thoát vĩnh hằng trong kiếp này khỏi vòng sinh tử luân hồi. Pháp môn Quán Âm đã được tu tập bởi tất cả các vị minh sư như Đức Phật, Chúa Giê-xu, nhà tiên tri Mohammed, hòa bình đến với Ngài, và đạo sư Nanat. Ngài đã nhấn mạnh, nếu chúng ta luôn tưởng nhớ Thượng Đế, phục vụ tha nhân một cách vô ngã và tuân theo luật vũ trụ, chúng ta sẽ đạt được tiềm năng tối thượng của con người và thực sự hiểu được mục đích của mình trên địa cầu này. Thanh Hải Vô Thượng Sư là một tấm gương sống phi thường về lòng từ bi. Ngài thường xuyên cứu trợ bằng hiện vật và tài chính, đồng thời gửi gắm tình thương cho những người tị nạn, vô gia cư, nạn nhân thiên tai và những người cần được trợ giúp khác. Vào năm 2006, Ngài đã nhận giải Wuxi Hòa Bình, được xem như giải Nobel Hòa Bình ở phương Đông, và được vinh danh suốt nhiều năm với rất nhiều giải thưởng khác, cùng những lời ngợi ca về hoạt động nhân đạo và thiện nguyện tuyệt vời của Ngài. Là tiếng nói chân thành cho các bạn thú xinh đẹp, Ngài khuyến khích lối dinh dưỡng thuần thực vật, hòa bình và bác ái, và những viễn cảnh tươi sáng. Với sự thức tỉnh của nhân loại về sự thiêng liêng của muôn loài, một thế giới thuần chay, bình yên và huy hoàng, nơi các bạn thú và con người sống trong hạnh phúc hòa hợp. Những sáng kiến của Ngài nhằm phổ biến xu hướng thuần chay rất đa dạng, bao gồm phân phát tờ rơi lối sống mới, chuỗi nhà hàng thuần chay quốc tế Love & Hope, truyền hình Vô Thượng Sư, cũng như trao đổi thường xuyên với quan chức chính phủ có tầm ảnh hưởng và nhà lãnh đạo giới truyền thông, cũng như tham gia các buổi hội thảo truyền hình về nhận thức của chúng ta đối với biến đổi khí hậu. Những nỗ lực của Ngài đã mang lại ảnh hưởng to lớn tới nhận thức toàn cầu về lối sống thân thiện với các bạn thú, và làm sao lối sống từ ái này có thể mang đến hòa bình trường tồn giữa các quốc gia, đồng thời cứu địa cầu khỏi nạn biến đổi khí hậu. Qua nhiều năm, Thanh Hải Vô Thượng Sư đã du hành khắp thế giới, từ châu Mỹ đến châu Phi, từ châu Âu đến châu Đại Dương, và đã tổ chức hàng trăm buổi thuyết giảng trước công chúng cùng các đệ tử về nhiều chủ đề tâm linh. Hôm nay, chúng tôi hân hạnh được trình chiếu một trong những bài thuyết giảng sâu sắc với tựa đề Mọi chúng sinh đồng nhất thể, học để có lòng tôn trọng, phần 1 của 3 phần trên giữa thầy và trò, được giảng bằng tiếng Anh, Trung Hoa và Âu Lạc, còn được biết là tiếng Việt, vào ngày 3 tháng 12 năm 2017 tại Tây Hồ, Đài Loan, còn được biết là Formosa.
<笑>厨房这么多啊越来越多听师傅上次有握手哈现在很愿意做哈哎小孩子好你好小孩子好 师父谁呀师父是谁呀好好好你好叫什么名字叫金明金明啊漂亮的名字你叫什么叫什么名字还不会讲话啊太小了太小了<笑> 还小也要来看师傅啊啊我从小就跟你讲过我也想要看师傅从小就是这样了还有一个那是别真的哦好乖好乖谢谢你了师傅我爱你你爱我哦谢谢啦再讲一次我喜欢听师傅我爱你我也很爱你谢谢你了哦你这么漂亮
头发就漂亮啊人也漂亮我就跟你我就叫妈妈帮我代替去跟师傅说金明也想看师傅好谢谢金明我也看你们很想看很想看我很爱你叫什么名字啊叫你叫你什么叫什么只能讲几句我爱你而已哈
哎呀，好有胆子哦！我们学校的同学都很喜欢吃我们那个素食的食物，对啊，都很喜欢吃我们家就是素食很多很多食物，然后都说很好吃呢，一直问我去哪里买的。哦，太好了！那你跟他们讲在哪里买吗？
我有跟他们讲。
然后就是他们说叫我帮他们买，原本觉得很喜欢，太好了，小菩萨又好的，再讲给他们学榜样，没关系了，他是喜欢诗人讲的，我喜欢给大众听，好，我介绍，好漂亮哦，你也会懂这个啊。 他说：“师傅好漂亮，你才漂亮，又年轻啊，整个辈子就在等你了，整世界都在等你啊，啊，哎，OK， 师傅老了，没你那么漂亮，OK，
以前呢，我也蛮漂亮的，小的时候，听说了，
听人家说了啊，
我知道师傅以前很漂亮，哦、
对了，谢谢你讲实话。” 以前才漂亮，听懂吗？啊。 你们都不跟他一样那么实在，那么坦白了 ，OK？ 小孩会讲真话，懂吗？ 哎，是是，小孩讲真话，嗯，哎，你好，<笑>哦，太好了，太好了，还舒服吗？还好吗？几岁了？多久了？多少个月了？10个月哦，还不会走路哈、啊。哎，小孩子，你好吗？哦，今天就给我那么漂亮，漂亮啊、哦，你很漂亮。你的妹妹，弟弟呀、啊，弟弟，哎。 对了，不过他小的时候不管了，讲都一样啊。不穿衣服讲都一样哈。好好好，哦哟，谢谢你来看，谢谢大家来收看哈，看戏啊。每个礼拜来看戏哈。嗯，你好。
妈妈救我们。
感恩师父妈妈救我们。哦，哎呦，会讲话嘞，那么小会讲了。
那是因为小时候的时候，奶奶一直都让我吃素，我吃6年了。然后呢，
就这样比较好哎，觉得好吗？奶奶其实一直都比较喜欢我。啊，是啊，我也喜欢佛啊。<笑>你看起来很漂亮，啊，别说素素好吃，嗯、啊。师父好。你好，健康 ，OK。 哎，大家那边好，<笑>对不起，地方简陋了，我尽量把自己弄漂亮，弥补一下。<笑>哎，你好，你好，嗯、啊，哎，怎么都剪头发光光，是当和尚啊，<笑>比较凉快啊，你也是 OK 吗？嗯，流行哈 ，OK 了，你们的妈妈来了，<笑>大家好哈，老人，老人都坐这里哈。<笑> 啊，是不是编你们到这边来了啊？为什么？老了就坐这里。<笑>好，那我也要坐那里哦。<笑>你们看起来还健康的啊，没什么老，嗯，没有那种疲倦的那种感觉，有吗？有吗 ？Yes or no？
<有>
哦， 因为你们有时候说没有，听好像有一样。 OK， 大家尽量划走 ，OK， 啊，因为我是很忙啊，最近比较忙一点，然后6只宝贝的狗也进来了啊，我也是很高兴啦，因为，因为他们还没来，我很担心嘛，已经好几个月了，看不到了，嗯，因为要等6个月才能来台湾嘛，嗯。 就是最近太忙了，4个月都没看到他们。我每天有跟他们讲话，说很快很快啊，这前天就来了啊、哦，嗯，政府也检查好了，他们健康了就放了。<笑>嗯，哦，不过我不敢让他们下来啊 ，OK， 让他们到处都跑，他们还小嘛。 还很小，还是小孩子，所以哇，年纪很多，我睡不着了，吃不下了，啊，本来要让他们在那休息嘛，比方说带出去了以后回来休息，哦，没有多久就要再出去了，昨天我放了出来，他到处都跑，我们还找不回来，吓坏了，因为第一次嘛，怕他们不认识的路啊，回不来啊，哇。 整个道场都到处都分配出去找，啊，还是终于找回来了。2个小时以后，哦，能不能想象他们找2个小时跑了，跑得好快好快啊！一看到就嗖，不见了，哎，在哪里？<笑>元气好多，懂吗？吃的多，睡得饱，只有妈妈吃不下，没时间睡觉，睡觉示范，懂吗？他们也是想跟着嘛。 粘了，好久不见嘛，然后就一直想粘，然后我又有工作，又专心了。哎呀，我不知道我为什么这个人那么多余的，这个时候怎么还能认养狗嘛？了解吗？本来啊，我认为，他们那些。 帮助的人啊，常常每天跟他们在一起，有没有？而且又四个月没见了。以前我在别的地方也不是能够有一些阵子可以天天看到嘛，有一阵子不能，所以我认为他们比较喜欢那些助手啦，啊，所以我比较安心一点。然后回来的时候呢，前天呢，我在那边煮饭一点给狗吃嘛，还有顺便给自己吃，然后我就要走了，就叫助手来看他们，懂不懂？哎，看他们还有擦洗那些碗筷那些啦，狗的东西。然后我认为，因为刚才有助手在嘛，以前呢，我还没煮了以前，他们有带他们来，所以有在一回。然后他助手出去，他就哭了，他们就哭了，在那个玻璃门那边是往外面的，鼻子都粘在那个玻璃那边的。我就认为哇，那他们就比较喜欢助手。当然，因为好久又都他们天日照顾嘛，我不在啊，懂不懂？我跟你讲，四个人的五六个人也照顾不了六只那个，哇，他们元气很，所以很多人要照顾，因为这样嘛，他们照顾，我认为啊，当然他们会比较喜欢他们了，因为他们对他们很有感情啊，狗啊对他们很有感情，很偏向他们了，他们就来就黏黏在旁边呢，舔舔他们的脸呢，懂不懂？说啊，好像很同情他们，我这个人没人同情，哎呀，他们不知道我多苦啊，在后面懂不懂？哎，饭菜也自己买的，懂不懂？然后也要煮给他们，偶尔了，不是天天的，什么都要煮住，他们才能够得宠啊，懂不懂？那个照顾那么好，都是师父在后面催动了，他们都不知道了，都是同情那些天天黏在一起。好，没关系，我说太好了，那就这样子，我就找那个助手过来，因为他们黏在那边哭嘛，啊，哭了一点点而已了，那种好像很留恋了、啊。我说好，那我叫他回来，因为我要上去工作了，就叫他过来。然后我说你坐这边跟他们在一起啊，他们比较喜欢你了。我现在要工作了，我一往门走哈、啊，大家都跟着跑哇。然后那些刚睡得很甜的，我棉被有盖好了，虽然有一些叫，有一些睡嘛，也冲出来了，都不睡，怎么这么快？我走路很近的，懂不懂？在里面没有鞋子啊，走路很近啊，大家知道了我出来了，通通都起来了，通通都跟着在后面想一起跑。然后好了，我就说好了，带他们出去，也许想出去，结果没有，通通跑到那个我房子那边，我工作那个地方，懂不懂？哎，以前你在香港也是这样子啊，有好几个地方，狗人啊，助手是住下面啊，然后狗就住在一起不同的房子嘛，分开一点点，这样有空间。结果他们带他们出去嘛，出去的时候他们就把那个助手全部都拉到我上面来，哦，拉得到这个样子，了解吗？我说好了，放了放了放了，让他们上来。一放他们匆匆跑到门口，跑到我房子上面了，尾巴摇了那个760度，然后在这边把我压下来了，整个全部狗都在我身上了。你们如果在旁边看不到师傅了啊，狗都在那边，都是看到尾巴跟那个舌头撑出来，那个样子，甜啊，啊 kiss 啊，懂不懂？啊，亲人啊，就是这样啊，他们会认识哈，会认识人哈。所以你们养狗的话，就要记得哈。不是说想养就养，然后不想养就丢给别人，不是这样啦。不管谁给他多少东西，不管谁那个给他多好东西，比你们好的，不管他的房子多大多漂亮，那比你好多，不管他的 garden 叫什么花园呐、啊，比你多大，不管你有没有花园呐、啊，还是你是他的主人，懂吗？他不理那些了，他不理那些了。在香港就住一个小房子，我们一起住的，他也是宁愿在那里，懂不懂？没有什么花园可以出去跑，没有草可以咬，他们还是一样喜欢在那里。在师父在的时候，狗他不会讲话了，了解吗？不过他们很懂啊，很懂事。昨天我要带一个最困难的那个狗出去， 为什么困难？因为他三岁的时候我才认养嘛，本来也不是，他不是属于那个认养那一对的 ，OK？ 因为那对只有九只小的跟一个妈妈，就十个，那个十九个也不是通通都是那个妈妈的，是他认养了，他只有三只黑的，三只黑就是他的，长很像妈妈，耳朵都是像你这样。别的都耳朵都是掉下来 ，OK， 而且颜色不一样啊，白的跟黄金的跟铜的颜色啊，铜懂吗？铜那种铁的铜啊，比较红红的一点啊，那个是最坏的哇，他是最爱师傅最黏的，不过哇，什么人？他比较活泼了，不是坏了，我意思说很活泼了，比较那个。脾气不怎么很那个啦，懂不懂？脾气不很平了，他跟谁都不怕了，来听吗？啊，不过他对师傅是非常听话的 ，OK， 很爱的。本来呢，那六只是被那个妈妈收养的，因为另外那些妈妈，三个不同的妈妈，每一只好像每个有三个，我是一个有两个，一个有四个这样。然后这妈妈被毒死嘛，我有讲过了哈，
是是，
现在高雄有讲过了，毒死，所以那这个通通都认养了，到他没有奶为止了，所以师傅收养的时候妈妈都没奶了，医生有说的，还好认养，不然的话他们就会饿死的，懂吗？哎，那个时候还不能吃那么多那种硬的那种饲料，狗的食物啊。啊，有一只最小的又不能吃那种硬的，因为它的舌头好像没办法，跟它的牙齿啊沟通了，所以有时候啊，他们就是它吃的时候，它舌头都怎么乱歪来弯去，然后那食物就掉下来了，所以别的都通通可以吃啊，我的要喂它，现在 OK 了，不过还是一样瘦的，因为从小瘦了嘛。他是最小最瘦的，因为从小是个子是这样。三岁的时候，不过他看起来很小啊，本来他是不属于那个十个在内的。结果啊，一个隔壁的那个佣人呢、跟我说，这只狗啊常常来跟那个妈妈玩，因为他也没有妈妈，他很爱那个妈妈狗的，所以他常来玩。就我看到他，我就说好，那就是这样，我们就都喂他了。那个时候。十只狗已经在我那个我已经收养了，就是那一个就没有进来，因为他偶尔来玩，他不是跟他们住在一起的，然后我就拿食物出来给他吃，他就来吃了，不过不会靠近的，懂不懂？你一出来他就跑掉了，现在还是好一点了，不过有时候还忘记了，还怕人了，懂不懂？因为妈妈被毒死嘛，以前也是这样，生下他一个人，他从小一个人长大了，没有人，他一个人而已。然后整个那个狗扶酒的那个人员呢、我就赔钱给他们，就通通去找这个狗，找不到，每一次看到他他就跑很远，他跑到那个山顶上面去，在那边就很多密密麻麻的，狗可以钻，人不行，他知道他那边安全了，每一次看到人催他，他就跑到山顶上面去，然后就不回来了，很久不回来。后来我就给他3万块那个泰币了，我说谁抓的全部拿到，他们就弄一个笼子很大，跟这个房子一样那么大，绿色，然后用那个草木什么把它伪装起来了。那是啊，他本来2天啊他不来的，平常我叫他每天喂一样的地方啊，他来的就用什么网啊就抓，结果2天他不来了，他们说也许他死了，因为那个时候很冷了，我也很担心，很冷，已经冷了，那个地方是冷的，不是蒙古那么热，夏天也凉，冬天冷，比较高山，比较北边的。然后这样呢，2天他不来了，到第3天大概太饿了，他大概知道他们的计划怎么样。第3、第4天呢，他 大概记忆力忘记了，他很清楚啊，很清楚，他大概躲在某些地方看到他们弄了很大的笼，不管多大他就知道，他就看到嘛，观察，所以不来吃了，不来一样的地方吃。第三和是第四天了，饿了就忘记了，就跑到里面吃，才被抓的。任何人抓他，他都咬的，他不是咬得很深的，不是故意的，就是为了自己要走开嘛。啊，后来呢就抓到了，我那个时候已经在别的地方了，开车大概我不知道三四个小时了，远了。然后他们就报告我，因为我说你们如果我现在要走了，不过你们抓到的话，就跟我通知，我一定会想你们那个3万块不跑的。不会跑的，以前已经给他们钱了，抓另外那几只了，这一次，哦，他们当然认真了，也不是为了3万块了。我在那个时候对他们很好，懂吗？他在我房子工作的时候，我就想他们很清楚啊，还有一起拿饼干、糖果什么啊，茶啊，饭菜给他们吃，对师傅高兴了啊。他们妈妈死，我还送钱呢、啊，送花圈什么的，懂不懂啊？跟他们同情的一起，然后他们知道我很爱狗啊，因为有那一只狗很病的，最少那个 hero 死的时候哭得很伤心啊，大家都看到，所以他们说一定，我们一定会找他的，你别担心，你走了，我们一定会找到他，一定的，我们答应，就很热情啊。他们知道我很爱狗吗？因为他们一起跟我埋葬那只狗啊，然后他们看我哭，他们也跟着一起哭了，他知道我很爱他们。好，后来他们找到了，就打电话给他啊，给那个比较会讲泰文的人了，泰国人了啊。然后那个泰国人当然会讲英文，那个就通知师傅说好，好了，那我就送他过去了，拜托你过去，因为他比较自由了，他自己工作比较自由，送过去就。找他回来了，找他回来。不过他说好像他比较弱啊，我说那马上找那个医生，那个以前那个照顾我另外那对狗了，赶快找他过来，因为他是最快的，他住很近，而且他很热情啊。这个医生蛮好的，他到处去帮助狗啊，或是被，比方说猴子哈，被人家抓了。在笼子里那种被陷阱了，他就会想办法把它打开。不过打开以前是要弄那个麻药，不然那狗猴都会，他抓不出去啊。他想把它抓出去带回去自己医院呢，先看看他有没有病，顺便照顾，懂不懂？结果呢，医生抓到了，就警察又来了，有人报警了，那些。打猎的人就报警说啊，那个是坏蛋的，把我的猴啊偷掉了，然后警察又把他关起来。后来他就解释，他说不是啦，我就是医生啦，我就常常照顾那些野外的动物，看他生病，我就弄麻醉的药才能够带回去看看。然后当然有证据嘛，哎，证明他是谁，然后。那个警察就放他了啊，不然呢？所以我看他那么好，我就给他很多钱了，叫他继续照顾。常常给多啊，因为我们不能每次能换那么多泰币嘛，所以能换多少我就留一些用，然后剩下就给他，他就很感激了啊。后来有一次我给。一大批的，他就出去把那些流浪的狗啊抓回来，然后结扎了。这样不然的话，整个泰国的很多流浪的狗啊，然后没有人照顾，然后都放到寺庙那边去给和尚养，好可怜啊！和尚本来是要离开世界嘛，安静修行，结果都养狗啊、乌龟啊、鱼啊、蝌蚪啊，还有他们很多那个佛教节日的时候嘛，他们想做福报有没有？就去买那些人家抓的那些动物啊，就放生，为了要做福报。在哪里放生呢？就跑到寺庙那边去，哎，所以和尚变成动物园了、啊，哎，寺庙和尚变成动物园， 我在泰国的时候也有贡献了啊，所以那个医生他做的好事，他做不过没有那种我只要跨洋了，然后他做完以后就来跟我夸而已，拿照片给我看，就是哦，就是我们今天有弄那什么多少多少都是谢谢你的，还有剩下的钱我有跟那些贫穷的人打那个打针啊等等，OK帮忙哇，谢谢你很多，我是不会，我才谢谢你。 啊，没有你，我也不会知道这些事情，也没有人能够帮忙。他叫他学生啊来一起弄绝佳，顺便学习啊，懂吗？也是很好。然后我说你有没有请那个电视或是报纸来看啊，叫上什么报道给泰国人看？他说没有啊，我们做这个善事怎么会要给人家看呢？不是给人家看，我说不是你要人家看。 是你要别的医生看，你要政府看，啊，然后做一些东西的，懂不懂？要模仿你的榜样，不然的话，有一个什么 program， 有一个什么计划，要挡一些那个流浪的狗，因为流浪的狗被毒死啊，常常这样，不然的话被人家会拿出来，然后剥皮啊，活生生剥皮，你们都知道了。对不起，这个是我不想讲的，太残忍了。 还有那个被人家拿回来吃的，懂不懂？所以你不能不广播出来了。下一次弄的话，要请电视，请那个你能请谁你就请谁了，报纸出来登出来给大家一起看，要学习你的榜样。OK， 不是你要夸的，我知道你是很谦卑的一个医生。他说：好，好，好，好，以后再说了。不过后来不就离开了吗？ 不知道他现在做怎么样。后来我就有一部车刚买的，大的，为了很多狗，就还没有开几次而已。有叫他们泰国同修啊，就把它卖掉，然后那个钱呢、啊，大概几万美金了，懂不懂？几万美金，就。 给那个几万美金在泰国是蛮多的啊，就去给那些养动物的寺庙啊，给他们和尚继续养。泰国的人他太好心了，他们认为他们放生的话，就要带到寺庙去超度了，懂不懂？给那些和尚顺便超度，然后当然不带回去啊，了解吗？哎，超度完就留在那边了，超度嘛，哎，他们超自己度啊，就。 每个寺庙都超可怜的，懂不懂？这要收养，收养狗、收养动物，不是收养而已啊。他们生病也要照顾啊，了解吗？跟你们小孩一样啊。不过当然不是照顾那么周，跟我们这边当然不一样啊。要插起他们，带到温暖的地方，房子里面跟我一起睡觉一样的，这不是了，懂不懂？ 不过是有东西吃啊，懂不懂？生病就有医生照顾啊，这样已经很好了。野狗本来就是这样啊，它不是说要很多东西了，吃就好了。OK， 啊，不过哇，你们有养狗就知道啊，哎，他们是要很多爱啊，很多时间跟他们玩啊，不是吃东西而已了。野狗是不一样啊，这些本来是野狗的，就不野了。 边在边不野了，他的妈妈也不野了，偶尔偷跑出去看世界了，野心难改了，偶尔了，然后在外面进不来，不晓得怎么跑的出去，就跑不回来。那个我们有篱笆嘛，不给他出去，结果他是想办法，他爬在树上，哪个地方有说一些书嘛，讲斜斜的，啊，他就爬上去，然后就跳过去。 就外面没有那种斜斜这个树啊，知道这放回来，就是没办法，然后就跑不回来，在外面哭了，哭了，我们知道了，就通通把那个篱笆剪了。哎呀，他在那个地方都没有门呐、啊，叫他进门的地方他不去啊，而且有时候不好跑啊，树木很多，我住都是那种。 高山那个森林的，所以不是每个地方都能够这样子跟着篱笆跑啊！啊，即使森林，我还是要把围起来，因为怕狗跑出去被人家抓走了，听懂吗？哎，然后又 怕动物啊，野生的动物跑进来啊，跟我们狗吵架就不得了了，所以去哪里都把它围起来，保护大家了，保护狗了。然后它就进不去，就在那边哭了，还是我们又捡篱笆，然后打开啊，带它回来，然后是摇尾巴了啊，谢谢谢谢，所以以后不要再出去。他说好，不会去，然后又忘记了，又再跑出去。奇怪的说，他们怎么跟你们一样呢？讲什么马上就忘记了啊！哎呀，然后我就说对不起啊，嗯，我每天听对不起，听到我那个头脑都满满都对不起，没有别的东西可以去。一说我自己方便的人啊，都对不起，有时候东西。事情不很严重的话没关系啊，严重了就不好了，了解吗？来不及改了，伤害别人，伤害大众是不好了啊。你们修行不是说头脑更清楚吗？会不会更清楚 ？Yes or no？Yes。什么？有时候会做那个不对的事情啊，业障哈，啊，是都是怪业障啊，太好了，有地方可怪了，嗯。OK 啦。国外来的人要不要问什么问题？因为我才能来嘛，要问什么吗 ？You wanna ask question? Yeah?
Con ước mơ nguyện vọng của con tha thiết rất là khao khát được gặp mẹ hôm nay, con gặp mẹ rồi con rất là phấn khởi, con kính chúc mẹ pháp thể an khang, tâm thân an lạc, cầu cho thế giới hòa bình, thế giới thuần chay.
Cảm ơn bác. Okay, anyone else? Hay là biết không? Mấy ông hả? Oh, thay hỏi là okay, very good. Nobody want to ask anything?有心理的问题要问啊，师父很愿意回答。以前有一位和尚嘛，他有一次他说他听到什么打雷的声音啊，不是什么声音，他修行的时候他说有听到声音了，然后他的师父就喊很大声啊，结果三天以后他就听不到任何别的声音了。大概他师父那个骂他等级怎么那么低了，懂不懂？啊，打雷的声音就知道哪个境界嘛？啊，有记得吗 ？Yeah， 啊，所以他师父大概骂他怎么那么小的，嗯，打坐那么久啊，那个浪费很多元气给你，叫你，然后今天才能听到那种那么低级的声音，还在那边夸嘛？所以他的师父喊了骂很大声，或是喊很大声，他说三天也听不到任何声音。有时候那个是软不行，就要吃硬嘛，是吗？啊，是不是？
是
你们小孩在家里是一样，有一些比较皮嘛，一是讲那个甜话不听啊，还是用那种比较硬的办法啦啊。不是要打他了，小孩他很快听了，不用打了，听懂没有 ？OK， 我狗是不用打了，我就拿我遗产啊，弄那个样子，他就知道了，要怪了，赶快进去具体的地方，我没有讲什么。那个大狗啊，刚来的时候比较凶嘛，对别的我的别的以前的狗不好啊，所以我没有跟他讲什么。我用那个我就拐杖了，他就停了，听懂吗？哎，他就停，狗会懂啊，了解吗？哎，我们人也懂，不要认为狗不懂啊，狗很懂啊，懂比我们多，就是他们装聋卖傻啊，当狗嘛，是啊，他装聋卖傻的，他们神通很多啊，帮助人很多，就是他们不露出来了，当然人也不知道啊。他们神通人看不到，有一些会看得到了，有一些有那种属于那种类似的神通就会看得到，会知道狗会做什么， 有一些电影啊，他们演出来就说狗他们合起来做什么什么帮助人的，有没有？然后用什么那边的沟通跟别狗沟通呢？集合狗起来，或是猫啊等等，那些不是完全那个假想的，你懂吗？都有一些真的故事在里面，所以他们才用那个真的那些故事啊，然后就编出来，多变成假的。 多余出来，懂不懂？不然的话，电影太小了。他们神通弄几秒、几分钟就不见了，懂吗？所以他们要再多加上去了。狗啊、猫啊，是你们养任何动物，他们都会帮助你们，那感恩不尽的。多数动物感恩心呢、啊，比某些人呢、啊、还要深，懂不懂？比某些人还要深。 比方说，你救一个人啊，不一定感激你，然后你收养他，他不一定对你，哎，有那个感恩或是爱心的，不一定。当然，你对他好，他会 OK 乖乖的。然后，万一他弄什么错啊，如果你骂他几句的话，就不一样了，你懂吗？他不想留，或是他做别的事情，他不再听了。我们越南人有讲那句了，就说。 你救动物的话，他们会报恩你的，会想办法报答你，来救人。他会，意思说报国，对不对？啊，good for 啊，意思说他可以找麻烦给你，有时候可以伤害到你的，历史很多了，懂不懂？历史有很多。 很多故事啊，人，你救他，反正他不报你的恩惠，又反过来伤害你，因为也许你有钱啊，他要多钱你不给啊，或是你给不够啊，或是他要全部你的财产啊，或是他要你的太太啊，他要你的先生啊，他要你某些东西啊，你的权位啊，等等，权利啊，都有了，懂不懂？ 我自己本人也有体验到一些，我们如果不跟人住久的话，就不会知道了，了解吗？所以最好离远一点，除了先生、小孩、太太了。OK， yeah， 我意思说，远不是说跟人家冷淡或是陌生那种的，意思说不要知道是最好。OK， 不要知道，对谁都好好就好了。 不要太多于介入人家的那个生活了，无条件是最好。OK， 因为如果你救他，带他回来自己的地方，然后就变成习惯了嘛，然后就介入他的那个决定啊、生活的方式等等，他就会生气了，然后就不好了。好，OK， 权力啊，跟那个富贵啊、富有啊，会变人的。 会把人变改得很厉害，很厉害。我有看到了，我有看到。本来没什么了的话，那一起可以工作了。后来比较有结果了，有成功了，或是有一些利益了，就会变人，会改变，会忘记这个世界是无常的，会忘记是。 我们尊严呐、啊，我们道德啊，是比任何的世界的保障还要贵重，忘记会忘记了，所以有人就说看到钱眼睛会黑了，意思是这样，不是眼睛变黑，就是盲掉了啊。然后有一点权力或是官位，就变成对人都不客气了，嗯。 本来呀、啊，当普通的平民的人就会抱怨了，就说哇，这些官僚嘛，哎呀，要求他做什么都好久好久，而且对我们都非常不客气啊，哦，让我们跑来跑去，好累啊，懂不懂？等一下他自己本人上去当官了以后，就比他也许还要糟糕，最少也是一样的，懂不懂？权力啊。 就会给人家改变太厉害了，所以我们在世界上如果成功某些程度哈，不用骄傲那么急了。 不要高兴太急了，那个也许是我们自己本人的陷阱了，然后有时候也被连累到大众的。你们看看报纸、看电视就知道了啊！多少人啊，本来很高的位置就被拉下来，到没办法在地了，坐牢了，懂不懂？坐牢呢，然后整个。 家庭也被连累了，你们看很清楚啊，看很清楚，知道哈，知道啊，最近也有发生啊，有没有？哎呀，我不要讲某些国家了，某些国家都一样，哪一个国家都一样，都有那种场合呀。当高位置了以后，也许准备要当总统呢，懂不懂？哎，大家整国家信任了，都就被拉下来，因为。 进入那个陷阱里面了，人家讲甜话，拍你的，懂不懂？拍你的，赞叹你的，啊，然后对你非常非常尊重的，那个时候你就要最小心。等一下他会让你到地狱去了，最小就到牢狱去了。嗯，当官应该很清楚。以前我们越南都说。 意思说，政府的人员就是人民的工人啊，用人啊，他们都是这样写的，到处都写，到处这样宣布的。不过不一样啊，看着光看呢、啊，做是不一样的，所以多少人呢、啊，多少官大官和是更大的领导人员呢、啊，总有一天呢、啊。 就还是被拉下来，因为这个时代啊，人民啊，他就不会这样忍耐那么久了。以前不一样，古代的时候，那个昏君啊，或是报官那些都可以划久一点，因为人民不好联络嘛，懂不懂？也不知道，又不知道谁是谁啊，不知道谁能信任，可以讲我的心事啊，啊，有关那些官员啊，抱怨的，不晓得。 谁会听我？谁会跟我同情，或是去报他报官的？所以他们都忍耐啊，忍耐很久。这个时代不一样啊，他们有那个 internet 啊 ，email 啊，有 skype 啊，有电话啊，有通讯，通通整个世界都知道。这个时候啊，你当暴君了，或是呢昏君了，整个世界都知道，不是你的国家知道而已。 不是你当那个无赖的那些官僚啊、官员啊，整个世界也会知道的，所以最好自己反省了啊。<笑>这个时代不能跟以前一样，太好了，我很高兴的啊。还有我很高兴，就是每天我就想想看，想不同的事情。这个时代我们真的很有福报。 我当然出来到这个世界了以后，当然小的时候都不大知道了。不过长大了越长大越知道，世界越来越文明了，越来越多那种神通哎，是不是啊？不是电话而已，以前我们不知道电话是什么样的东西啊，是吗？电视根本没听说过，是不是 ？Internet 根本这是什么？你讲什么东西？没有人听得到，没人讲出来。 现在我们什么都有了，懂不懂？我意思，我生出来这个时候是太运气太好了，太有福报了。你们也是运气很好，是吗？哎，当然，当然越来越多了，越来越多发明的东西了。不过，我们这个时候已经很舒服了，是不是？ 啊，有暖气呢，有冷气呢，有没有啊？电风扇呢？哦，以前呢，当国王也是很痛苦，啊，要赚很多衣服，有没有？不然的话，他们就说不赚钱，啊，好多衣服。你看像啊，现在比方说你现在看过很多了，不过如果公主结婚，比方说日本公主结婚，12层啊，12层衣服，以前呢。 国王都是要这样这么装的，装的到走不动了。<笑>像那些很年轻上来当国王呢，幼年的，因为父王 早往生嘛，然后幼年呢、啊、几岁而已啊，还没有到十岁已经上来当王，有没有？能不能想象坐在那边？他想去尿尿也不行，要等。啊，穿那么多衣服在那边都是转得很紧紧，又不能动，不能笑，国王不能笑。嗯，哎，是什么种类的国王？那放一个 robot 在那边就行了嘛 ，robot， 啊，不能笑，不能动摇太多，脸都是这样子，硬邦邦的，才是有庄严嘛，有没有？人家才怕你，怕什么嘛？啊，我这样装，你们怕吗？怕不怕？总理没看你们怕我，总理没，你们会笑而已。刚才我装那种脸，你们都笑了，看到没有？表示说都不怕嘛，装什么脸有什么用啊？他们就训练那种国王，懂不懂？你不能道歉，你弄错也不能承认，你不能谢谢谁，懂不懂？你都是理所当然，大家都为你是服务的，你不能谢谢。哦，当那种国王会受不了。会疯啊，是吗？几天而已，会受不了。而且那些那么多那个太监啊，什么宫女啊，什么太妃这方面，哦，每个人都要你的一部分啊，懂不懂？他要你整套了，对了。不过当然不能要整套国王啊，就每个人都能咬多少都咬多少，整天这样子。怎么国王好久没有来我的那个后宫啊，等等，了解吗？然后那些官员也想看啊，想拍国王，为了要到好处，了解吗？哎，跟国王要好啊，啊，哎，真的很累啊。当总统也差不多啊，懂不懂？当然很多人拥护你啊，看起来非常非常那个隆重啊，啊，非常有威仪。不过他们也要东西啊，没有人无条件的。这个世界，美国人他们说 "There's no free lunch"， 啊，懂了。没有什么免费的，所以国王什么都也是很困难的，当总统也是很困难，所以他们弄错的话是要谅解了，要谅解。主要就是他不很大坏蛋的那种，听懂吗？不能大坏伤害人民的，太暴力，太那个，一说伤害到别人的权利或是生命的那些是当然是混进了啊，贪污啊那些也是不好了。了解吗？不然的话他们弄错一些不大错误就要谅解。 OK， 是有了，是有一些有谅解了，不过有一些他们弄变成很大的，懂不懂？嗯，因为生生世世啊，其实总统也没有两样啊，就讲不出来，因为喝迷魂药嘛。我们平常都碰到前世认识的人了，平常都这样，不管敌人或是那个恩人啊，会互相碰到。世界很窄了啊，不要说世界很广，不是不是，常常碰到，有没有啊？你们知道哈？有吗？哎，有，一定会碰到。有一些你看到就很面熟嘛啊，然后越靠近越觉得很讨厌，因为。前世是看到很面熟就想跟他当朋友，哎，越当越讨厌了，因为以前是冤家敌人，对的。然后有一些人看起来很面熟，不过也没有什么因缘可以继续那个当朋友了，就很怀念啊。碰到一两次也是很怀念，就是因为前世是恩人啊，我是家人啊，我是情人啊，我是丈夫太太 ，OK。所以我们当然为了修行。 Why are you sitting so low? Can you see me? You're supposed to sit up here. Come up. There's a corner there for you. And you also. Come up here. There's a lot of place. You like it there? Okay. That's a small guy. Come up there. Because you cannot see me. You keep doing this. I'm worried your neck will become habit. Then you walk around like this. No? Yeah. Okay. They're also fine. Anywhere. You can come up, my love, if you want. It's a little late, but it's okay. Come up, please, if you want. If you don't, it's okay. If you don't, it's okay. If you want, you come. Okay. Next time, remember, okay? Because the Taiwanese, they're squeezing around and you're not used to it. Okay? So that's why I let you sit up here. Also, you're from a long way over there. Here, I'm very busy because many things I have to do, okay? Please forgive me if I don't have retreat for you and then that I sit with you 2 months on end and every day give you cakes and candies and bedtime story, okay, huh? Now it's a different time. I have to do more things, okay? I have to do more things. Even I neglect my dogs. I cannot always play with them and cook for them or, you know, just whenever I really have time. And they, of course, they sleep same room with me. But that's all they have, okay? And then now and then, scratching the neck. Oh, good boy, good girl, okay? And at bedtime, scratching the head, massage a little bit here, everybody, a little bit, a few seconds. Good boy, good girl, sing a quick song, and then good night. Light out. You see what I mean? Yeah. And then I continue to work until 3-4 o'clock in the morning. And then sometimes the phone ring again. Oh, Master, we have more documents for you to check. I have to check. Even though I've been training them and SMTV has been a long time, I always have to check. You have to learn, okay? You have to learn. You know, right? People experiment with words. If they put certain words on the bottom of the water, then that water become murky. If you put certain blessed or how you say positive word, then the water clean. See that? Water only, and you look down upon water that you use every day. Wash your hand, clean your dirt, but you don't clean your karma. The water knows everything. The air knows everything. So be careful what you think, what you say, okay? Or what you write to people. Because everything knows everything. We are not just covered in this flesh body. We are transparent soul. Capisce that? Your mind is connected with all beings in the whole universe. So don't think nobody knows what you're doing. Learn to have respect, okay? Even the earth knows everything. The trees knows everything. I told you many times, but do you really understand or not? I should learn to have respect, okay?
Yes.
Must, okay?
Yes.
You come because you're wise, because you know this is not the real thing that you want. This world is not your world. Comes because you are very, very, very knowledgeable about what is good and what is fake for you, okay? And you chose the road to walk because you know exactly this is the way you should go, okay? Because you want God above everything else in this world. That's when you should come in, okay? Not come in because many people follow me, not even that. You have to agree to my teaching, understand what I said, and know that is exactly what you yourself wanted to say, if you have a chance to say, okay? If you haven't met me before, this is exactly also what you wanted to say. If you can formulate it, you will say exactly like that. Because you agree with what I said, okay? And you understand it, because that's exactly what you think. Then you should come in. Your time has come that you should come in. Don't come in because of any other reason, okay? Except for God. Except for the Almighty God. Except for your own highest nature. You know, the Buddha nature, God nature within you. Okay, huh? Yeah. And tell anyone who follow you the same thing. Because you are also a mini master of some kind. Eh? Oh, you can talk, right? I know that. You can try to convince people. You can. And oftentimes you can. Oftentimes you also fail. Because that person, maybe his time is not up yet. His time has not come yet. Okay? Or maybe he doesn't like the way you act, or doesn't like you, or doesn't have affinity with you. Maybe some other sister can convince them, Maybe some other brother can do the job, but that doesn't mean anything. Yeah, you do what you can, okay? Affinity is also important. Yeah, that person has no affinity with you, no matter what you say, they don't care. Okay, all right. So just give him whatever you think he need to read, yeah, from master, sample book or something. Be friendly, and it's okay. Leave him alone. Don't try to force too hard. Okay. All right. So it's all. That's it, huh? It's done. I think 20 minutes up. Tell me, is it 4 o'clock now? 4:30 already? Oh, man. Really? How can 20 minutes pass so fast? Oh, I cannot believe that. Every time with you, things are so fast. You know, like I get out of meditation and I want to see you. Of course, I want to dress and I want to take a shower. I want to brush my teeth, everything. But the time so fast. I say, my God, I have only 30 minutes. How can I not finish anything yet? And it's just even for me only, you know. I haven't even eaten anything since yesterday. Of course, I ate yesterday late because sometimes I don't have time at lunch. I forgot also what lunch is, okay? And today, of course, I cannot have breakfast yet. I never can have breakfast. Morning is, I have to continue the meditation and contacting heavens for many important questions and issues. Understand, sometimes I don't contact them, they contact me. So I have to check out what is it? Is it urgent or not urgent? And it takes a lot of time, yeah? They don't just print it out for me like on the paper, black and white, and I read it. No. I have to check one by one letter, and put them together in one word, and then to the next one. Understand that? I have to go through the whole alphabet to get one letter right, put next to the other letter, and continue until the word finished. Got that? Yes. Take a long time. And not to talk about sometimes it's blocked. Like recently, I lost. Hey, 你们如果饿就去吃饭啊，然后要回家就回去了. Sometimes, because I talk to the foreigners, they don't have to go home. They are here to stay for at least a couple of days and a week or 2 weeks. So it's okay. I talk to them in English. Everyone else is hurry or want to eat or something or go home because of. It's okay. I talk to them in English. Everyone else. Is hurry or want to eat or something or go home because of business or busy, just go, okay, huh? Now, like recently I told you I lost 62% and then continued to lose another 1.5% afterward for different reasons. But I get it all back. But it was truly hell. I'm not swearing, okay? I swear. If you don't like that word, just put H and LL. Everybody understand? H, point, 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 and LL. Okay. Now, oh, it was terrible because they cannot contact me. They did, but I can't. I have no power to receive it, and I have no power to contact them at all. You know, the newest one, the most powerful. The more I go, the more powerful. Okay. These are the one more accurate. For words, affair, and peace, and everything else that I need to know, or I should know. Even for my dogs, you know. Oh, for my dogs, I can ask a little lower God. But for the world as it is right now, the lower gods cannot do anything, cannot help much, understand? But at least, when during the dry period of time, I have only 20-some percent to use, you see, you understand? I can't contact any goddess that I used to do before. Oh, it was really terrible. And I'm just like sinking in a pool of water without knowing how to get up. Understand that? Could not even cry. It was so suffocating and very, very depressing, very oppressive, very... difficult to explain, understand? I feel like, my God, I'm just like you feel like you're doomed, finished. Nothing you can do now, nothing you can even pray to get out of this, nothing. You know, completely helpless, hopeless and dark. Oh, it was terrible. I wish I don't ever have to do that again. And then slowly, again a little bit back, you know, a little by little, Oh my God, I just have to no sleeping and for sex, whatever. I don't even, sorry, I didn't bath since I told you before that. Also, I lost them before I told you, of course. And then after seeing you, I lost more, of course. And then all the things to do, take care of dogs and bureaucracy and all that, even lost more. Even 1%, you know how much is that? Hmm? It's not even gazillion. You see, it's, I don't know, imagine as much as you can, time gazillions, understand that? As much as you can, I don't think you can imagine how much it is, even 1%. Therefore, you don't think, oh, Master lost only 1%. You know, after seeing us, how much can that count? It does count. So after even again back only 9%, I was able to contact some lower God, an informative God. Understand me? Before that, oh, shut. I'm just alone completely in like in a coffin and still have to continue to work. Understand? Using only my own physical and whatever I have, you know, in this physical world, just like you. A little bit better, of course. But that is just for working, nah? For working, for SMTV, for doing things for everybody, not for me. For me, I have nothing. Not even half an answer for anybody. I ask some God the name, I call him the name. And it's all blank. And one very, very weak answer from some information God, after I gain a little bit, 1%, I say, nobody here, nobody there. I mean, nobody waiting for me, nobody answer me, nobody get me. Nobody can hear me, nothing. So it's the same in hell, you understand that? In hell, when you are in hell, you can't even pray. It's all blocked. Even God hear you, you don't hear the gods. Even God hear you, the gods hear you, they can't help you. You see what I mean? You have to pay your debt, karmic debt, until you finish. And then they can help you. Therefore, use the time when you are not in hell now. Use the time when you have human body. Use the time when you have spiritual power. Okay? To pray, to meditate, to continue contact with Godsis. Okay? God Almighty, you cannot contact. I'm sorry. You can contact, maybe, but not directly like that. Okay? Yeah, maybe through... Yeah, whatever. I don't want to say too much. Okay, I'm very shy. I told you already, okay? Yeah, I'm very shy. All right then, I go now. Remember God's, remember the five holy names, remember to meditate, remember to be good, do good, and think good. Okay, huh? Yeah. Thank you for coming. Bye then. They told me today is warm. I asked the driver and she told me it's warm. It's hot even. She told me it's hot. So I'm wearing this. But thank God I have some clothes inside. It's just numb. No problem. I'm healthy. Okay? Strong. Powerful. Okay. I want to speak to the foreigners and the new initiates in the thing because they probably have questions. I don't dare to ask. Also, I don't have time to answer here, okay? In the public kitchen. Come on.
Thanks for your love.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for your love. Come on. Thanks for your love, okay? Thanks for your love. And thanks to Taiwan for helping them to have food to eat. They like it very much. Thank you. Thank you. 大陆也可以上来，也是外国的，懂吗 ？OK， 带你们继续上来，我会讲英文啊，也许讲中文，不过不知道了啊，随便啊，看谁问了。OK， 谢谢台湾拥护。OK 哈。他们呢、啊，他们外国人都说你们非常好客了，非常爱心了啊。也许因为我们住这边的关系，那个得那个客家人的传染嘛。 客家嘛，他们是很好客就对了，呵呵太好了，OK， 我们找到对的地方了啊，嗯，谢谢，不会觉得冷呢 ，OK， 好了，我走了哈，我上去替你们再接客了。我也是客家人，懂吗？好客，安子些，安子些。 看大家一点，看大家一点点。<笑>哦，对不起，这边都没电视啊。哪里？我看不到。哦，不过就这边看不到啊。啊，对不起的。要不要放电视在这边给你们看呢？啊？意思说放在路边啊。<笑> 因为你们都是住路边嘛，是吗？哎呀，哎，I love you，I love you。你们讲英文啊，太好了，小孩这么年轻会讲英文呢，啊，然后你们那些老人叫你们学，你们都不学。OK 了，啊，再见了，师培 OK， 以后见了，啊，love you，I love you， 我爱你们，非常爱 ，OK。 我爱你哦，会讲话，爱你，他很害羞了，他只会是人讲，他不喜欢麦克风。OK，记得，爱你，爱你，你们，我爱你，好温暖吗？温暖吗？哦，谢谢了，谢谢。OK，我爱你。啊，我是靠你们小孩长大当好人哦。OK。 哪一个刚才啊？再见。大包包，大包包过来。大包包，包好了就走。别人要包，别人要包，大包大包过来。
好了，你先，你上课了，他别，他不骂他，我们自己去上。 Thank you, Master.
Anh
hiểu xem
á?
Anh hiểu
Permisa yang berbahagia, kami menghargai kebersamaan Anda untuk episode hari ini yang berjudul Semua Makhluk Terhubung, Belajar untuk Menghormati, bagian ketiga dari tiga seri dalam acara antara guru dan murid. Tetaplah di Supreme Master Television untuk lebih banyak lagi acara positif. Akan hadir selanjutnya adalah Cara Terbaik Untuk Belajar Adalah Melalui Pengalaman, bagian ketiga dari tiga seri dalam acara Kata-Kata Bijak. Semoga Anda hidup setiap saat dengan cinta, rahmat, dan rasa syukur. May you be living every moment with love, grace, and gratitude. For more details, please visit suprememastertv.com/BMD.